If you suffer from pain, swelling, and limited function in your joints, you need to see a rheumatologist. What happens when all your tests are coming back negative or so-called normal? Some of you will get a diagnosis of seronegative rheumatoid arthritis. In this video, I will educate you about the most important aspects of the seronegative rheumatoid arthritis diagnosis, and I will answer the most common questions that I have in my clinic. What is seronegative rheumatoid arthritis? Can seronegative RA mimic other types of arthritis? Is seronegative RA more aggressive than seropositive rheumatoid arthritis? Can seronegative RA become seropositive? And is the treatment different from seropositive rheumatoid arthritis?
RheumatologistOnCall.com.
Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Girnita. I'm a board-certified rheumatologist and the founder of Rheumatologist on Call. If you're new here, welcome to my YouTube channel, where I educate people about autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis and the best methods that you have to thrive with arthritis. So don't forget to subscribe and never miss one of my videos. What is seronegative rheumatoid arthritis? I think it is essential to understand that rheumatoid arthritis is the most common autoimmune disease that I, as a rheumatologist, see and diagnose in my clinic. Rheumatoid arthritis affects approximately 1.5 million people in the United States. Females are more affected than males. But before we make a diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis, we pay attention to the clinical picture. The classical pattern of rheumatoid arthritis involves pain and swelling in the joints, especially in the hands and feet, in a symmetric and bilateral pattern. So hands, feet, shoulders, knees, and ankles will be most of the time affected simultaneously. Morning stiffness is also characteristic and usually lasts more than 1 hour, and it is improved by movement. Then, to help with the diagnosis, we order labs and x-rays. The laboratory tests that we commonly order for patients where we suspect rheumatoid arthritis are rheumatoid factor and anti-CCP antibodies, along with other labs that I will discuss in another lecture. Now, when researchers look to see what are the percentages of people where we see these markers positive, they have found that only 60 to 80% of patients have a rheumatoid factor positive, and only 65% of patients will have an anti-CCP antibody positive. And about 20% of cases, none of these markers are positive. So, if those markers are positive, or only one is positive, I diagnose my patients with seropositive rheumatoid arthritis. If none of these markers are positive, I will diagnose the patients with seronegative rheumatoid arthritis. That meaning that, as I said, none of the markers that I mentioned, rheumatoid factor or anti-CCP antibodies, are present in the bloodstream of the patient. To make things more complicated, none of these markers, rheumatoid factor or anti-CCP antibodies, will actually make a diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis. These markers could be used in conjunction with the clinical picture, the time of onset of the symptoms, and sometimes we do see elevated markers of inflammation. Now let's return to this concept of seronegative rheumatoid arthritis. Can seronegative rheumatoid arthritis mimic other types of arthritis? The short answer is yes. A recent study published in 2021 showed and proved that many patients initially diagnosed with seronegative rheumatoid arthritis developed other forms of arthritis in the next few years. From 9,700 patients initially diagnosed with seronegative rheumatoid arthritis, approximately 560 patients changed their diagnosis. Out of this 560 patients, 48% had psoriatic arthritis, 43% had ankylosing spondylitis or axial spondyloarthropathies, and the rest of them had inflammatory bowel disease-related arthritis. Some situations like Sjogren or lupus patients can also present with signs and symptoms that looked like seronegative rheumatoid arthritis. That is why I always recommend and obtain at least a test called ANA at the beginning of the evaluation of my patients. In 2019, there was another study published that identified other causes for seronegative rheumatoid arthritis, like polymyalgia rheumatica, gout or pseudogout, paraneoplastic arthritis, which is an arthritis related to cancer, giant cell arthritis, and more rarely, juvenile arthritis. But this is quite common in rheumatology, as many autoimmune diseases develop over years, and that's why we diagnose patients initially with seronegative rheumatoid arthritis. In my clinic, I have diagnosed patients with seronegative rheumatoid arthritis that later on proved to have, for example, psoriatic arthritis. But to learn more about psoriatic arthritis, the most common signs and symptoms, I have posted a video in my channel. If you are a patient that had psoriasis even many years ago, you should tell your doctor about that. If you are a patient that suffered from Crohn's or ulcerative colitis, you should also mention that to your rheumatologist. If you also have lower back pain, frequent episodes of tendinitis like Achilles tendinitis, elbow tendinitis, or even inflammation in the eyes, you should also mention about all of this to your rheumatologist. These symptoms might indicate that you suffer from axial spondyloarthropathy or ankylosing spondylitis. Again, if you want to learn more, I published many videos in my channel about ankylosing spondylitis. Is seronegative rheumatoid arthritis more aggressive than seropositive RA? There is an ongoing debate. The truth is that we still don't know. In seropositive rheumatoid arthritis, we know that certain risk factors like the presence of anti-CCP antibodies are associated with more aggressive disease and a poor prognosis. However, early diagnosis, aggressive treatment in the early stages of seronegative rheumatoid arthritis can potentially stop the inflammation and prevent further damage to your joints. Being proactive and under the care of a rheumatologist will also help you better manage your disease. Can seronegative rheumatoid arthritis become seropositive? The answer is yes. Some patients will become seropositive in time. However, we don't know the percentages of patients that will become seropositive. Now, the question is routine testing recommended? Not really. But in certain situations, your rheumatologist might decide to retest you to make sure that you did not develop another type of autoimmune disease. Is the treatment different for seronegative rheumatoid arthritis? Once the diagnosis of seronegative rheumatoid arthritis is made, your rheumatologist will discuss your therapy options. The treatment is not different from seropositive rheumatoid arthritis, but it will need to be individualized to your specific medical condition or medical situation. As a general rule, the rheumatoid arthritis treatment is done in a stepwise approach, starting with the least aggressive medication, such as non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medication and hydroxychloroquine, and then advancing to other disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs, such as methotrexate, leflunomide, or sulfasalazine. More targeted therapy is indicated if none of these drugs are effective or if you are not able to tolerate them. These medications are collectively called biologics. If you want to learn more about biologics, watch this video in my channel. Biologics is a general term for many medications that target molecules that produce inflammation in our body, such as TNF-alpha, IL-6, or JAK enzymes. For treatment recommendations, you should always discuss in depth your clinical situation with the rheumatologist that will be able to answer your specific questions. Now, thank you for watching this video. I hope I was able to make you understand better what it is seronegative rheumatoid arthritis. If you want to learn more, if you like the educational content of my video, I will invite you to like, share, and subscribe to my channel, and maybe share this video with people that you know are suffering. Thank you, and I will see you very soon.
RheumatologistOnCall.com